This is an incredible moment. The future is here.
What pulled you into this in the first place? Like, this was a blind spot for me. I really didn't remember this story until watching the documentary.
I know, I was 9 years old when Biosphere 2 happened, so I had no recollection of it either, but I was poking around the internet and I came across this photo of 8 people in these bright red jumpsuits, just like us right now. And yeah. I thought it was actually an image from a sci-fi movie. And then it didn't take me long to realize that this was in fact a real project and these people lived quarantined inside Biosphere 2 for 2 years. And at that point I was just determined to tell their story.
So when did you start this project? Because it's kind of a weird time that it's being released now. It's very relevant.
Oh, I mean, I never could have predicted. I started the film 1.5 years ago and I thought, hey, it's really relevant. It's about a group of people trying to live sustainably on Earth. Mm-hmm. And we premiered it at Sundance. And I mean, nobody could have anticipated a few months after Sundance that we would be quarantined, but the film has taken on this whole new dimension.
Yeah, has it changed meaning for you? Or do you feel like the tone has changed in a way since before and after quarantine and the way people have responded to it?
You know, it's interesting. It's made me think about quarantine in a really different way. And I think the film is ultimately inspiring. And a big part of that is that these people who went to live quarantine for 2 years inside Biosphere 2 came out transformed. And they had a different insight about the effects that they had on the bigger world and what their responsibilities were. And I think that would be pretty great if we all come back to this new world after coronavirus and we think about each other and how we're accountable to each other.
Yeah. So how much footage did you have at your disposal? Like, how much did you go through?
We had 600 hours of archival footage, which for me isn't that weird. Like, I'm used to working with that much material, but I know it sounds like a lot. But yeah. What never happens when you make a film is, this is a film, the plot is crazy. There's a lot of twists and turns in this story. And it's pretty amazing that there was footage to show you every part of the story. So you're really in it. It feels like you're back in 1991.
What did you expect going in versus the outcome?
I mean, I always go in open-minded and I like ambiguity. I like when things aren't clear-cut, cult or visionaries. It's in life, we're all good and bad. We all do amazing things and stupid things. And this group was both kind of amazing and insightful and also wacky. And that's what I liked about them. There wasn't a clear answer, but I did believe that what they did was significant. And I wanted to understand better what came out of Biosphere 2 and why it's relevant today.
There was quite a few celeb cameos.
I mean, I think what was amazing is just the 90s, I mean, to me, it feels like it wasn't that long ago, but it's actually 30 years ago. And it's just so campy, like the way people's clothes, the color of the carpet, I mean, everything from the 90s doesn't feel recent. It feels super vintage in this campy way. And it was just fun to look at that and to lean into what's funny and campy about this story. But there are some funny celeb cameos in there too.
Was there anything in terms of when you're sitting down with these people today that was off limits or they didn't want to be sensationalized or they were trying to stop you from doing?
No, it wasn't. Nothing was off limits. I mean, I had to put the time into earning these people's trust. They did this huge project that was this media spectacle and then was really torn down. And in a lot of ways, their life's work has been totally discounted. So there's a lot of pain there, and I had to be sensitive navigating that to get their trust. But once they were on board, these guys felt like they had made history and they wanted people to know their story.
Well, I think we've seen a lot of, especially lately, these like very sensationalized documentaries where the subjects afterwards are like, ah, this isn't what I signed up for. I don't like this. So this felt very like balanced. Was everyone that participated happy with the outcome? What did they think when they saw it?
Yeah, I mean, we waited until Sundance to show the film to the subjects. So that was a pretty nerve-wracking premiere screening for me. But when they came up on stage, there was a standing ovation. And I think that was a real life-affirming moment for them to see that people could tell what they did was important and that they want to recognize it. And it seemed like a transformative moment for them too. So I felt good about it.
Have you thought about what your Terranaut name would be? Because my favorite person was AKA Horse.
Yeah, Mark Nelson went by Horse and also Green.
Is that a self-dubbed name or?
I think it's a little bit of both, like group consensus and personal brainstorming, but the whole crew of our film gave ourselves nicknames. Mine was Coffee Bean because I'm hyper.
Now, did you visit the Biosphere 2 facility?
Oh yeah, I visited, and one of the Biospherians, Linda Lay, gave me a personal tour where we got to go behind the scenes. So it's an incredible, spectacular building. It's like a pyramid in Egypt, except in the middle of the Arizona desert, and people visit every day. You can go, not right now, but once things open up, you can go make your own pilgrimage to Biosphere 2.